Now, the fiscal cliff has a lot of us on edge, no pun intended. Unemployment is high. Natural disasters have caused destruction and loss of life. And something so awful and hard to believe as the shooting in Newtown that targeted so many children. It's enough to really test your faith. Joining us live from Chicago is Father Robert Barron, a Catholic theologian and founder of the Word on Fire ministry. Father, many people out there are saying that this is evil, that Mr. Lanza, this young man, that this represents evil. I mean, how do you define evil?
Well, in the Catholic tradition, evil is never a positive force that opposes the good, but it's always something entirely negative. It's a lack of a good that ought to be there. Think of like a cavity in a tooth or a cancer that compromises an organ. It's not like the Star Wars cosmology where you've got the dark and light side of the force battling, but rather evil is always a lack of a good that ought to be there. So in the case of moral evil, it's a twisting or perverting of the will, which by its nature should seek the good.
And how do we know God is listening?
Well, God is love, and God's attentive to every aspect of his creation. I mean, so God hears the cry of the poor, as the Bible says. God's attentive to all aspects of reality. People ask me a lot, where is God in Newtown? How is God present there? The right answer, I think, is in every act of love. All those teachers and counselors who gave their lives protecting those kids, that's where God was present. God's present now in all the attempts to respond to this tragedy with compassion and with love. That's where God is found. And yes, God's attentive to every aspect of his creation, especially the suffering corners of his creation.
It's a tough lesson. What words do you have for folks in Newtown this holiday season?
You know, I think the key to it is that in the biblical perspective, God's love is more powerful than anything that's in the world. Think of how in Christianity we put right before our eyes this image of Christ crucified. What is that but the greatest outrage in human history? The putting to death of the Son of God. There's nothing more horrific, nothing more terrible, more tragic than that. But what we say is that God's love, manifested in the resurrection, is more powerful than anything that is in the world. So at Christmas time, we hear from the prologue to John's Gospel. We hear that the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness cannot overcome it. It's not a question of the darkness being utterly eliminated. Rather, it's the light that is more powerful than the darkness. I think that's the core Christian message in the face of terrible suffering.
And how do you, a couple of days ago, a large percentage of the world believed that the world was coming to an end. I'm sure you study history and theology all in one. How do you put all these things together? It just seems a very uncertain time.
Well, I think we're always living in uncertain times. I mean, if you go back over history, almost every generation has said we're living in terrible times, and they probably were right. There's something just very precarious about our existence. That's why only in God will our souls find rest, as the Bible says. We seek satisfaction and we seek stability in politics and cultural events and great personalities. But the biblical sense is that none of that really provides the ultimate foundation. It's only in God that our souls are at rest. So we're always living in precarious times. Okay, all right. So we turn our lives over to God and find our comfort there.
Father Robert Barron, thank you very much. Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Merry Christmas. Thank you.
You can see more stories about faith on our belief blog at cnn.com/belief.